In this video, I'm going to be breaking down for you the most common use case that we see across all of our Airtable clients, and that is building some sort of a CRM or client resource management tool inside of Airtable. If you're ready to get out of spreadsheets and start stepping into the future of technology and software, you're going to love this video because I'm going to show you how to build your own custom CRM in just a few moments, give you plenty of tips and tricks along the way. If that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you get the full potential out of your no-code tools through no-code education. So in this video, as I mentioned, we're going to be diving into one of our favorite no-code tools, Airtable, and we're going to be showing a lot of the different things you might consider when building a CRM. We're going to be doing this specifically for 2024. We're towards the end of the year. A lot of new enhancements have been added to Airtable and we're going to leverage them as much as we can. But before we get into the heart of things, I first want to invite you to join me for some training. I've got a free Airtable crash course put together. You can sign up at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course. We'll include the link wherever you find this video. And if you sign up there, you're going to get the basic building components of Airtable sent to you in email. So in this training, I break down for you all the core building blocks of Airtable, one at a time, step by step, so that you can unlock the full potential of Airtable in your business. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. We're going to start building our own CRM from scratch, but we're going to be actually leveraging some AI. So obviously AI is out in force in 2024 and Airtable is no different. They allow us to build an app with AI. So we're going to do this right here and we're going to get a little bit of a prompt. So here as an example, tell us about your world. I work at test company. We're in this industry. I build apps for this. Let's skip this and we're just going to go right into what we are building. So we're going to say building a CRM system that includes, and I find it really helpful to whenever I'm working with an AI builder, tell it the different tables of data that I'm looking at creating here. So I'm going to say that includes tables for, and then inside of here, I'll use parentheses and I'll list out all my different tables. Now, all CRMs are going to have the contacts table. Most of the time then, a contact will link to an organization, but not always. In our particular example, I'm going to be imagining contacts that link to an organization. So we might know multiple people who work over at Acme Company, for example, and we're going to have those in two different tables. So I'm going to say companies is a separate table. Now I'm going to also think about the type of work that we do and what we're trying to use this CRM to track. Usually a CRM is going to include some element of lead flow, deal flow, like you're going through the pipeline process, we're going through some sort of sales process, and ultimately we then have to deliver our service or product to you at the end of the actual sales process itself. So in our example, again, we're going to imagine that we're a service-based company and we are going to go through, let's say, projects, and we'll attach those projects to tasks. So I'll say we also have projects, tasks, and we might have some sort of deal flow table as well. A little TBD on this one, if I'm being honest. I'm curious to see what the AI puts together for us, but this is what we're starting with, building a CRM that includes tables for this. And I'll give it a little bit more context as well. I'll say we are a service-based company and we will use this tool to track our leads through our pipeline and ultimately deliver services. All right, so let's go ahead and just set this up. We've got the settings here. We can set up our organization, industry, audience, if we would like. I'll skip it for now. We're just gonna go to next and it's gonna build the tables for us. Now we can do this ourselves in Airtable pretty quickly, but it's so much faster to have the AI do it for us. And as you're going to see in a moment, in many cases, we can have the AI doing more for us than just building the back end. So here you can see that the app that they've built also includes two forms. They've put in contacts, companies, projects, services, deal flow. We can add additional things. So it's recommending, hey, maybe you also want to track in things like services, invoices, employees, etc. So you can see already how much time we're saving putting together an app through using an AI builder like this. I can, of course, choose a color for my app. I'll go with this nice blue here. And let's say create the app. I can select more of these tables if I need to. I don't for our purposes. I'm just going to create from here. And this is saving me a ton of time. Especially if you're new to Airtable and you haven't leveraged their building before, you've never built a database, this is going to do most of that heavy lifting for you, and it's getting you to that final thing, that final product, way faster. Now where we are is actually inside of our interface. And this is one of the beautiful things about Airtable. If you're newer to the software, you need to understand that there are three layers to Airtable. You've got the database, how everything is related. But then the database also has automations that live inside of there, so we can build automated processes. And then we also have the interface. And this is how we're actually moving things and we're getting work done. When we are in our day-to-day operations, we don't want people looking at the raw data, they're in an interface. And so the AI builders put all of that together for us. Now I'm going to edit the app. I want to actually look at the guts of it. Here I'm actually editing the interface itself, but you see when I click on edit app, in the upper left-hand corner, I have my data, my automations, and my interfaces. And I am currently in interfaces. If I want to look at the data, this is what I'm going to click into. So here I have my five tables. This is a core building block of Airtable. Every table represents a set of data and they can be connected. So here we have our contacts and you can see that they're linked to companies here. This is a link to my companies table. And so over here in companies, the reciprocal of every link is also true. So if a contact connects to company, then a company is also linked or connected to the contact. And so here we are, we can see the companies that we work with. We see our projects over here. Our projects are linked to a company and to a contact within that organization or company. We have tasks related to our projects, so a linked relationship there. Over here, we have our tasks, so the different things we're working on. And of course, these tasks are related to a project. We don't have tasks that just exist out in a bubble. They're connected to something. And then lastly, Airtable has built us this fifth table. And again, we are testing this out for deal flow. So we've got this deal name in various stages with a value. We are tracking the source of this. We're adding a close date, what we're estimating anyway. And you can see that we have a contact person and an associated company for the deal flow. So that's our back end. I would strongly recommend that if you're building your own CRM, you have something very similar to this. Generally, we have contacts, maybe companies if you do B2B, and then we're connecting to projects or some sort of operation. And then we also have then some way of tracking our deal flow. What are the different things that we're working on in our pipeline and how are we moving them through the process? Now, the best part about this, of course, is to go to interfaces here and then see how we can actually interact with all of this. You can see we've got all of these different interfaces here. We have companies, projects, tasks, a different interface built for each of the tables that we have. Now, once we publish this, let's actually select all of them and publish. This is a live version of our database, but this is how we would actually interact with it. And we would share access to this with our teammates. And so in order to do that, we just come down to share, add people here, and we can add them either to the specific interface or we can add them to all of the interfaces. So if we just wanted people looking at deal flow because they're on the sales team, bring them in here. And if they're on the operations team, they need access to projects and tasks, for example. So this is, you know, fully live, fully functioning. And we can go through here, click into these different things. This is filled with sample data, but it gives you great visibility into what is possible. Now, the big thing I don't want you to sleep on inside of Airtable, especially if you're new to this, is understanding the power behind automations. So I'm going to actually click into our data again. This is taking me back into the back end of this solution. And here we are, automations. Now, automations don't get created yet by AI. We have to learn how to build them and build them ourselves. But you can imagine so many different things here. Like, for example, when people reach a certain stage in a deal flow, maybe we need to send out contracts for signature. We can do that all via automation. If we have a standard contract, we can send specific information to the contract, make it out to a specific client, send it on out once that particular deal reaches a certain stage in the pipeline. Another example for automations: automating emails, automating task creation, automating reminders inside of Slack or Microsoft Teams to let you know that maybe something needs to get an extra set of eyes or have some extra attention. There are so many different things we can do with automation, but the true magic behind it is it will take away those repetitive, mundane tasks that you do already. You don't have to think about them anymore. Now they happen on autopilot in the background. So be sure to pay some attention to automations and take advantage of this as well. But as you can see, it's very simple and easy to stand up a very lightweight, easy to use CRM. This, of course, can get infinitely more complex depending on your needs and the specific way that you do business, but this is a great start. Strongly recommend checking out the AI generator, building a CRM as I've shown you here, and really leaning into not only the interfaces, but also the automations. I hope you got a ton of value from this video, and if you did, be sure to subscribe to the channel, give us a thumbs up, swing by the website if you need any help, but most importantly, keep on building.